The year is 1925. The Burbank brothers are wealthy ranchers in Montana, and at the Red Mill restaurant on their way to the market, the brothers meet Rose, the widowed proprietress of, and her impressionable son, Peter. This is The Power of the Dog on Night at the Movies.
"25 years since our first run together. 1900 and nothing.
It's a long time.
What you doing?
Getting mixed up with her.
You are marvelous, Rose. We were married Sunday.
I wonder what little lady made these.
I did, sir.
Well, Brother Phil?
Open up the gate. Let him out.
You sure he's not ready?
Go on, let him out.
He's just a man, Peter. Only another man.
A man's made by patience and the odds against him.
For what kind of man would I be if I did not help my mother?
Peter!
If I did not save her.
Sort of a lonesome place out here, Pete. Unless you get in the swing of things.
So, Mikey, Power of the Dog, Benedict Cumberbatch playing a 1925s Montana rancher with his British accent. What's your thoughts on the movie?
Well, I just need us to both be either in agreement on this. Is he, you know?
Yes.
Do we think he's? Okay, thank
yes.
God.
Okay.
I'm like, I'm not about to have a whole argument about going with easy.
Yes, he is.
Okay. Thoughts on this movie. Jesse Plemons is kind of hot.
Okay.
Cody Smith McPhee is a great actor. I think Kirsten Dunst was a little overhyped. And Benedict Cumberbatch, he did a very, very good job. My biggest issue is this story was just so contrived and boring, and the script was lazy.
Okay, you kind of took a lot of things I was about to say out of words, but Cody Smith, great actor.
Probably going to win the Oscar.
Probably will win the Oscar for this role. He did win the Not So Golden Globe Awards for it, but he did an amazing job in this movie. The entire time in this movie, though, I kept on referencing to my husband, "Hey, look, it's Nightcrawler off of X-Men. It's Doctor Strange. It's MJ from Spider-Man."
Oof.
The entire time, because that's all I could see, because the movie was so drawn out and lazy. And this is the point in time when I'm going to say something very controversial. It was a bad movie to make. It was a bad movie to make in this time of age. I understand why they made it, because Hollywood's having this identity crisis right now. But for those who read the book.
Oh, you read the, that's a book?
Yeah.
Did you read the book?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
It was a book?
Yeah.
You learn something new every day, folks.
There was a lot more in it. So I was upset.
Yep.
I was upset. And it seemed to drag on. Benedict Cumberbatch plays a haunted man quite well. Quite well. For those who watch it, he is a brother who is tending to cattle in 1925.
He's a rancher.
Rancher, sorry. And he's having issues because at this time there is the height of the anthrax pandemic that is going through the cattle in the United States. So it was trying to stay away from that. Cody Smith, I forget his full name.
Cody Smith McPhee.
McPhee plays a potential love interest of Benedict Cumberbatch's character. He teases him. He becomes kind of a father figure. Before Michael watched this, he asked me what to expect. And I said, it's a cross between Call Me By Your Name and Brokeback Mountain. Did you agree with that statement?
I mean, it was so subtle, the gay. Like, I just, like, I wasn't picking up on it as strongly. It was just a little too subtle. I also didn't understand the motivations of, like, any of the characters. Like, I just don't understand, like, at the end, Cody McPhee, like, his motivation with the, like, cow. I didn't even understand what had happened. Because they didn't even make, they did, it was so, like, it lived in the subtle. And I don't necessarily like that because it just was boring. It was difficult to watch. It was exhausting to watch. And the acting was great. The acting was very, very, very good. I'm not going to sit there and deny that. But I feel like the bad acting made this movie a little bit better than it actually was. Because I think that the script was awful. It was just a contrived. Like contrived 2.5 hours, and it could have, you could have cut 40 minutes and it would have been fine.
Again, it seems like we were on this kick of movies are a lot longer than they should be. If anyone's listened to the last 6 episodes, you know that the running theme in these Night of the Movies on the cross-border interviews is cut your film. Just because you have 2 hours does not mean you need to fill 2 hours.
Or even 3. If you have 3 hours, don't do it.
This is gonna be another controversial statement. Jesse Plemons
is hot
and Kristen Dunst. I did not get any chemistry from them. And it's ironic because they're husband and wife. In real life, they're husband and wife.
Wait, really?
Yes.
You cannot tell me that. Those people is not married.
They are married. And since 2016, they've been married. And they have 2 kids, and the entire time I was like, these two do not belong together in the movie. And well, the entire time
they
they
didn't share enough actual screen time together.
Yeah.
It was like a star vehicle moment for Kirsten Dunst and Benedict Cumberbatch, and that's it. And the only person who actually is going to get star vehicle from this
is Cody.
To his award is Cody.
Yeah. The cinematography was good. The landscape of epic proportions of, hey, here's New Zealand in 1925 when it's supposed to be Montana. That pissed me off because the entire time I was like, oh, when's Gandalf going to come in here? Because I could tell that it was New not Zealand. Montana. I could tell. It's not that hard to look and go, it's
the
not.
Kid was a little psycho, cutting up the rabbit.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just think that Hollywood, we need to do better when we're going to make movies. Like,
so the reason why we decided to review this movie is because it is a leading contender to be the best picture, best director at the Academy Awards. Now, for full transparency, we are recording this prior to the nominations being announced. So we do not know if it's actually being nominated or not. At the Not So Golden Globe Awards, TM cross-border interviews, trademark cross-border interview with Chris Brown, it won Best Picture, Best Director, and also Best Supporting Actor in a drama. I am concerned that if this gets nominated and
it will get nominated. If it wins,
okay, let's go with that. The Academy is going too far to the gay card. We've had Moonlight. We've had this. And we had Call Me By Your Name.
Didn't win.
Just I know, but just because you have a gay-themed movie does not mean it has to be nominated.
Well, I agree with that, but I also think that maybe it's time to stop telling these stories of trauma.
Yeah.
For the queer community, I think it's, yeah, tell stories, but why does it always have to be fucking trauma? Why does it always have to be some sad fucking heartbreaking ending? Granted, by the end of this, I was so thankful it was over.
My husband said the exact same thing as we were watching. He's like, this was the worst 2.5 hours you've ever made me sit and watch. I then had to make it up by watching one of his movies, which was about some haunting of something or other.
The Haunting of Hill House?
Sure. Okay. So I, if you want a good movie for its photography, watch this movie. If you want a good movie for storyline, do not watch this movie. So we are going to go to our star rating now. And anyone who's watched these knows that we mark these out of 5. Michael, out of 5, what would you give
the Power of the Dog? I want to give it a 1, but the acting was very, very, very good. And it did have good cinematography. The script was just so bad. Yeah. I don't know. I'm very torn between like a 1 and a 2, which we don't do halves. So nope. I need to jump off the fucking half and put it at probably, I'll round it up. I'll give it a 2.
You round up? You always round down. I'm a half glass, half empty guy.
No, that's why I'm an optimistic little angel.
Out of 5 for me, I'd give it a 1. I was not impressed by this movie. I do not see why the critics are fawning over this, because the even at the Toronto International Film Festival and the award ceremonies for the Toronto International Film Ceremony, they gave Best Director to the person who directed this, Jane Campion. I don't understand it. And I don't understand. I get that, okay, it clicks a lot of the boxes that you need for a good Oscar film. For me, it just wasn't there. I'm sad about it, but I had so much hope for it too, because I'm a big Benedict Cumberbatch fan.
Did a good job. It's just
shitty. You got to see his ass and part of his penis. Well, if you saw Jesse Plemons' ass, you'd probably say something different.
I sure the hell would.
So that is The Power of the Dog, a night of the movies on the Cross Border Interviews. What the?